everybody. Norma here. How are you this Wednesday morning, November 18th? We're about a minute out to get started this morning. I am back in the aerobics room here at work, so I hope that you can hear me okay.
So we are going to start in Shavasana. For those of you that are joining live, or who may be doing this at a later date and I haven't met you so far. Good morning, my name is Norma, and I'll be guiding you through your practice this morning. So go ahead and get settled on your back in Shavasana to start. It is a beautiful morning here in Hamilton. Beauty of teaching or attending a morning yoga class is that you begin to greet the day maybe a little bit earlier than your normal routine. And as people who know me know, I'm not really an early bird, but I love this opportunity to flow in the morning. And the sky was so beautiful and inviting this morning, reminding me the value of making the time to do an early morning flow. So we are going to work or concentrate on our solar plexus this morning in our practice. So nothing to do right now with your solar plexus, but just letting you know that that will be our focus. And so we'll create some heat on this colder morning. And of course, always an opportunity to stretch and relax as we go through. So allowing these first breaths to let you land here. Knowing that there's nothing for you to do. You have carved out this 45 minutes just for you. Forget all your to-do lists. Concentrate on you and this little piece of rubber mat, your yoga mat, that is welcoming you back home. Whether this is your first time unrolling your mat ever, or this week, or this month, or maybe this year, can you feel how your mat supports you and welcomes you back home? Feeling the parts of the mat where you are connecting, back of your head, your shoulders, your hips, the back of your hips. To earth here, letting it you anchor here. And bringing your attention to your breath, just awareness, no need to change anything. And just do a scan of your body. How are you feeling this Wednesday morning? Is there any area that may be feeling a little stuck or tight? And offering your breath to those areas. Seeing if you can soften just a little bit more.
Just a little bit more. Taking an inhale breath together. In through your nose, open your mouth, sigh, let it all go. Maybe imagining your solar plexus, this yellow wheel of energy just above your navel. Using your breath to maybe ignite that flame. And come back there to see how it grows as we warm up. Create some fire within. So stretching arms overhead, just waking up from a long nap, taking knees to chest, curling in, bringing your head and shoulders up. Give yourself a wee hug here. And give yourself the love that in this hug that you would give anybody else. Allowing head and shoulders to come back down and begin to rock and roll along your spine. Feeling that little massage starting to warm up. And when you feel ready, crossing your legs and popping over or finding your way into tabletop. Maybe that's something we'll work on in the new year. So setting your foundation in your tabletop. Let's just invite movement to our bodies here. So any authentic movement that your body may be craving here. And there doesn't need to be any rhyme or reason to it. You can even close your eyes if that feels okay. Maybe point back into a modified child. Coming up with that scary Halloween pack. What feels good in your body this morning? Allowing yourself to listen to your body and let it guide your way. Inviting a breath that travels in through your nose and exits your nose. Just that slight constriction in the base of your throat, kind of like you're snoring. And when you feel ready, find your way back to a neutral spine in your tabletop position. Toes can be tucked, or toes can be flat on the mat here. Extending your left leg long behind you. Finding your balance here, engaging your core. Breathing that left foot long behind you, foot is flexed. 3 points of contact here with your balancing table. And if you want to test your balance a little bit, engage your core a little bit further, allowing the right hand to come up, palm faces center, letting that arms sit back in your shoulder there, allowing your shoulder to slide down your back. Not holding your breath here, feeling your body warm up, engaging that core for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice. Take your right hand down, left knee meets right, and shaking your hips from side to side. Let's try a second side. Standing right leg long behind you now. Checking in, getting your balance here. And when you feel ready, breathing that right foot long behind you. Your foot is flexed. Finding your balance here, engaging your core to keep you center line. Want to challenge your balance even more. center, checking in. Am I sinking anywhere into my right leg or my right hand? Fours, firing up here. Five, four, three, two, one. Nice job. Taking your left hand down, right hand comes down. Maybe just some small circles here to release your hips. And breathing. Alrighty, let's do one more round, just with a twist. So setting your foundation in your tabletop, neutral spine to start. Left foot goes back, stepping long behind you. Checking in, and we have your balance here before raising your left foot up long behind you, foot is flexed. And when you feel ready, letting right hand float up, palm facing in. And can you bring right arm, left leg to center, curling in. Touching your elbow to your knee if you can. Breathing back up. Do that again. Inhaling, curling in. And exhaling, balance the table. One more time. Inhaling, exhaling, curling in. And exhaling. Right hand comes down, left knee comes down. And shaking your hips off. Feeling that fire growing. Solar plexus, your power center, allows you to have vitality and strength, but also balance. Okay, what we do on the one side, we do on the other. Neutral spine to start, right leg extends long, catching your balance here. As you breathe, your right leg long behind you, your flat foot is flexed. When you're ready, floating left hand up on the center. Inhaling to prepare, exhale, curling in. Right up knee, left elbow. Exhale, brings you back to center. Inhaling, curling in. Exhale, long. One more time, curling in. Back to balancing table. Letting left hand come down, right knee meets left, and let's just circle our hips. One more time, maybe extending long into this child's pose just for a breath. Not wanting to stay there too long as we're just starting to warm up. If your toes aren't bent, totally tucking your toes and lifting your hips up and back to your first downward facing dog. So you may not find that you need to warm your hips up as much this morning as we did a lot of warming on the ground today. But just check in, is there anything that your body needs here in your first inversion? You can offer that. When you're ready, finding stillness, bend generously into your knees, look into the top of the mat, and can you travel there? You can tippy toe, you can take a big step, or maybe it's in your practice to jump. Just checking my screen here, I was going to use another device, so I'm just on my phone here, so I hope you can see me okay. Inhale into lengthen, flat back, exhale, pulling in. Rising all the way up, bringing all that back into your heart, near Tadasana, your mountain pose. Allowing hands to come to your sides just for a breath, feeling that connection, that strength in your feet. You're rooted here and on earth. Can you inhale, rising up,
stepping back and allowing the first flow to flow through your body. Honoring your body, high or low plank. Over up dog. Down facing dog. Always an option to travel to the table on the way down. Three breaths to reset. Offering a cleansing breath here if you have anything to let go. Breathing your right leg long behind you. Bending your knee, curling in. Stepping or helping your right foot to the top of the mat. Bringing left foot up, a foot or two up your mat. Foot is on the 45, toes are pointing to number 11 on the clock. Breathing up into your warrior one. So left heel's flat on the mat. You're bending into your right knee. And focus here on your arms, engaging your arms here. Pinkies turn in slightly. Just imagine you've got like a beach ball here that you're holding on to, so the arms remain engaged. Letting your hands come down, stepping right foot to meet left, flowing it out. Always an option that these flows aren't serving you today to stay in your down dog or your child's pose, as those are our home bases. Breathing your left leg long behind you now. Curling in. Stepping or helping your left foot now to the top of the mat. Right foot steps up, it's on the 45, toes are pointing to number one now on the clock. Breathing up. Warrior one on your second side. So checking in with your balance here. If you're feeling any wobbling or that you're feeling tight in your hips, you can stretch your right foot out a little bit further. That felt better in my body. And to your knees. Left knee. Allowing your hands to come down. Left foot meets right. Rinsing it out one more time here. Maybe your cobra is coming up a little bit higher as you're warming up. Down facing dog. Three breaths. Pivoting on the back foot so it opens up to the short edge of your mat. Coming in to the right knee.
Allowing your arms to float like wings, warrior two. Flipping right hand, reach it up and back to exalted warrior. So really focusing on your core as we're going through these postures. Engaging it, seeing that fire burn. Coming back to warrior two. Taking hands to hip, taking right foot to meet left, and then this wide-legged forward fold. Maybe just heel toe your feet in once or twice, and turning your toes out. And seesawing your legs until you find your goddess squat. Just change the side so you can see me. So you want to make sure that your tail is tucked, feeling that fire in your legs, also engaging your core here. Hands can be at heart center, your cactus arms, maybe even saying hi. For five, four, three, two, one. That was for you, Lori. Letting hands come back to hips, letting legs free up, jiggling things off, letting right foot find just front of your mat one more time, pivoting on your back foot, letting hands come down, left palm plants underneath left shoulder, twisting open to your lunge twist. Right hand comes down, left foot meets right, rinsing it off with your second to last vinyasa. Maybe upward dog as we warm up, if that's in the practice. Downward facing dog. Nice job. Three breaths here to reset. And when you're ready, breathing left foot up, palm behind you. Curling in, stepping left foot to the top of your mat, you're helping it there. Finding your expression in your crescent lunge, allowing your right knee to come down, walking hands up your knee, bending into the left knee. Or if you want to, pop your knee up. Find high crescent lunge, you do that. Refining your cactus arms one more time. Open your chest up here. Bring high in your back toes, bending deeper into the left knee. Nice, nice. Engaging that belly. Letting hands come to your waist, pivoting on your back foot, opening up into your warrior two, second side. Letting your arms float like wings, shoulders are long down your back, far away from your ears. Flipping left hand, reach it up and back, exalt your warrior. Back to warrior two, checking in, letting hands come back to your hips, pivoting your left foot now on the short edge of your mat. You're in this wide-legged stance to start, knees are slightly bent, not locking out our knees. Inhaling to lengthen, exhaling, pouring forward, one vertebrae at a time, head comes down last,
You can find the floor with your tippy fingers, or maybe have a block. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhale, folding in. Walk your hands over to right foot, finding your calf or your ankle with your left hand. Inhaling to prepare, exhaling, opening up, twisting your body. Inhaling to lengthen, exhaling, letting it go. We're walking over to left leg now. Right hand finds your calf or your ankle. Inhaling to prepare, exhaling, twisting over to the left side now. Letting left hand come back to center, walking your hands to center, inhaling one more time, exhaling, grabbing right elbow arms, and just let everything hang here. Just slight micro bend to your knees, not locking up your knees, not in your head yet, so shaking your head no. Allowing hands to come down, walking your left foot back to front of your mat, pivot on your right foot, planting right hand underneath right shoulder. One more twist, your lunge twist, decline or forget it. Letting left hand come down, left foot meets right, and rinsing it out with your final vinyasa. Maybe find your way to child's pose, because that's where we will meet. Nice flow, everybody. Maybe you're feeling the heat that your body's created. Feeling a little bit more awake.
And everybody's doing okay.
Great. So finding some stillness in your child's pose, knees can be close together, engaging your hips back long behind you, or maybe you widen your knees as wide as the mat, bringing hips, your seat, long behind you, and you can let your hands go by your sides, or maybe palm faced up if you feel like you would like to receive some energy here, or you can put your hands in reverse prayer if you want to engage your arms a wee bit or start to back your arms out. Lots of options.
And those of you who have some tight hips, you might say, Norma, your hips are up in the sky. They're not down by your heels. So that's the goal. Just like in your down dog, you want to engage our heels to our mat. And with our child's pose, we want to soften our hips towards our heels. If you have anything going on with your hips, any tightness there, it may look like your bum's still up in the air. Yes, I said bum. But that will come as we lengthen and use our breath. And just like your down dog, your seat may never find your ankles in this posture. And that's okay. Honor your body where you are. And it may change from day to day. child's pose was a pose that I struggled with when I first started doing yoga, similar to pigeon, as it's a posture that if you do have things going on in your hips, that it's a little bit more challenging. And this is where our props can come in handy. If you have a prop, you can place it underneath your head, or if you've got a bolster, you can have that bolster long and straddle your legs with the bolster and find more comfort and ease in this posture. Bringing your attention back to your breath. Mind begins to wander. Sometimes it does as we're holding these postures just a little bit longer. Let's inhale together. Exhale, open your mouth, silent, all go.
When you feel ready, letting yourself come up, maybe wiggling off your hips from side to side. Finding your way onto a seat. And I wouldn't be any good as a teacher if I didn't offer boat pose in a core class, right? So here we go. Before we find our ways to our seat, we're going to find your expression of your boat pose. So feet are flat on the mat, hands can be below your knees, or they can find the backs of your legs here. And just finding yourself tipping back on your sit bones, maybe coming up on your tiptoes. And inhaling, imagining that flame in your core getting brighter and brighter. So this may be expression of boat. If it feels okay, you can float your feet up. Engaging your core, protecting your back, or maybe your hands come out. That's in your practice. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Feeling shaky, we haven't done that for a while. Letting feet come in, crossing your legs. Folding over, letting it go. Let's do one more. Finding your foundation. Feet are flat on the floor. Hands by your legs, underneath your thighs, just the back of your legs. Tipping back on your tippy toes, on your sit bones, finding your sweet spot. Engaging your core, allowing your feet to come up. Long, neutral spine, nice. If your hands are coming out, let them go there for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stay with me. Allow yourself to find the ground, one vertebrae at a time. Woo! We made it. Nice job. So bending your knees, letting your feet find the floor, heel toeing as wide as your back, toes facing out, knees lock in, hands can be by your side, palms face down. And let's begin to windshield wiper our feet, our legs from side to side. Next time your knees fall to the right, leave them there. You can take your right heel, anchoring down on your left knee. If you want to get a little deeper into the stretch, you can feel it deeper in your left hip. Right hand can be on belly, and your gaze can be over your left shoulder here in this twist. Your breath to lengthen once again, your heart begin to settle down. Your inhale lets your left foot find the ground again, right leg is crossed, your left knee, figure four position. This may feel okay in your hips if you want to get a little further into the stretch, needling your hands through the opening of your legs and gently bringing left knee towards your nose. And a sleeping pigeon. So it's really a pigeon, we're just nicely on our backs. Feet are flexed to protect your knees. Only come into this thread the needle posture if it's not compromising your breath or scrunching up your neck and shoulders. And breaths here. Checking in, is there any place that you're holding on to? Maybe you aren't even aware that you're holding on. Let it go. Letting the thread of your needle come down, left foot finds the mat, right foot comes uncrossed. Finding your wide stance again, toes are pointing out, knees locked in just for breath to start. And once again, finding your windshield wipers from side to side. Time your knees fall to the left, we're going to leave them there. Hooking your right, left foot over right knee if you want to get deeper into the stretch. Left hand can be on your belly and your gaze can be over your right shoulder this time. Next inhale, let's your right foot find the ground. Find this figure four position now. Left ankle is still at right knee. You can stay here on your tippy toes, reaching through the eye of your legs, finding your thread, the needle. But once again, a reminder that when we do that, it's not compromising your breath. Causing into stress in your shoulders or your neck. And can you surrender here? 10 more breaths. Letting your thread the needle let go if you're there, letting right foot find the floor, uncrossing your legs, and bringing both knees into the chest, head and shoulders come up. Give yourself a hug one more time, curling in like a little ball. Before coming back down, head and shoulders relax, feet extend long, letting toes fall open, finding your Shavasana posture. Maybe tucking your shoulders in or finding your cactus arms. What position is going to let your body feel cozy here for your Shavasana? And if you were in person, I would dim the lights. And maybe you find your socks or your sweater. Enjoying your rest, your Shavasana. And knowing that I will be here to bring you back when the time is right. Enjoy. May you be at peace. May your heart remain open. May you awaken to the light of your own true nature. May you be healed. May you be a source of healing for all beings. Feeling your breath one more time. Slowly inviting small movements into your body to wake yourself back up. Maybe letting the light come into your eyes. Massaging out the back of your head as you gently invite one ear to your shoulder. And when you feel ready, rolling over to one side or the other, whichever is calling you, maybe staying in your fetal position just for a breath or two, soaking in your experience, your practice today. And when you feel ready, finding your seat, bringing hands to heart center, Ajna.
taking this moment to honor yourself for taking this time just for you. Noticing any changes that your practice may have brought to your body, your heart, or your mind. Practice today. Know that the love and the light in my heart bows to the love and the light in your heart. Namaste. Have beautiful days, guys. I hope that you get to enjoy this weather. I think we're going to have a nice warm day for November. That's awesome. And you feel some fire. And you get to do something that you're passionate about. I will see you next time. Have a great day. Namaste.